Ashley Creed.
And I'm Alex Ryerson.
And welcome to another exciting edition of Hop Talk. Hey Alex, what are you doing this weekend?
I think I'm going to hang out with some friends. I don't know. Just chill.
Better be in by one.
What? Why do I need to be in by one?
We had a curfew, remember?
Not anymore. You know what? Check it out with Epiphany and Siobhan.
Hey Seahawks, did you know that Myrtle Beach doesn't have a curfew?
No, I was not aware that Myrtle Beach, the city of Myrtle Beach, did not have a curfew for students or young adults.
I thought we had a curfew.
I thought they did.
No.
Did I know that they don't?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I knew that we had a curfew.
In February 2009, a curfew was put in place to help Myrtle Beach youth stay out of trouble and to keep them safe. But in 2010, the law was taken back. Why would you put a law in place only to take it back? This is our investigation.
We found out that on the same day the curfew law was put in place, a helmet law was also put in place. Then in 2010, the South Carolina Supreme Court ruled helmet law to be invalid, and that decision is affecting other laws as well.
Since the city's helmet law was repealed, the associated laws of the bill were also repealed. The curfew that would have said everyone 17 and under must be inside from 1 a.m. until 6 is no more, but it is still a wise practice for your own safety.
Now that we have told you everything we have gathered, what do you think? What is your opinion on curfew in Myrtle Beach?
It would be a wise thing for them to do. You can only get in trouble being out too late, and being out late usually leads to trouble.
No.
Yes, we should.
Well, I think it's necessary for some people.
But I think it's good for some people.
I don't mean to be shit for kids or like people under the age of 17,
No. There's too much stuff that goes on. You guys are too young. I don't think you should be out that late.
1 to 6, I mean, truthfully, I don't even think that we should. I mean, we shouldn't have a curfew because we basically gonna stay out either way it goes.
Even though there's no curfew, that doesn't mean you must stay out all night. We encourage you to take responsibility of yourself and have a win-win situation.
That's it, Seahawks. I'm Epiphany Holmes.
And I'm Siobhan White.
And we'll see you next week on Hawk Info.
Have a great weekend, Seahawks.
Have a great weekend.
That's very interesting. I still think it's a good idea to be in by 12, so be proactive, Seahawks.
Yep. You know what, Ashley? My favorite thing about spring is baseball, a great American pastime.
You know what I like?
What?
Soccer.
Soccer's good, too. Well, both of our favorite sports are on this week's Hawk Talk Sports, so let's take it away with Mikayla and Spencer.
Lay.
Hey Seahawk fans, I'm Spencer Gray
and I'm Mikayla Eady,
and this is Hawk Sports.
This week was the kickoff for spring sport games. Girls and boys JV soccer played Saucastie High School. Girls played a tough game but were sadly defeated by the Braves. Boys had a great first game with a win over the Braves. Also, on Tuesday night, boys and girls varsity soccer team played Saucastie. It was a must-see game. Girls won in 2 minutes left in the game. You had to be there to see it. Way to go, Tori Zelter and rest of the Seahawk ladies. Boys played a great game. They never gave up the whole time. They ended up winning in overtime by 1 point. Can't wait to see what they have for the rest of the season.
Also a great game to the varsity boys baseball team.
When they see me off in traffic, they say Jeezy on some other shit. Send them running straight back to the dealership. Me, I'm in my spaceship, that's right, I work for NASA. This FNH is not a fraud, call that
I'm Spencer Gray.
And I'm Akala Edie.
And this is Hawk Sports. Catch you later, Seahawk fans!
You know one of the aspects I like about our school, Ashley?
What's that?
Our diversity sets us apart from everybody else.
Yeah, we've got a lot of kids from other countries spreading their customs and trying to learn English also. And I'm proud to send it over to our boy RJ to tell us more about it.
Good morning, Seahawks. This is RJ International Show.
Shimano Seahawks.
Salam Seahawks.
Sinchao Seahawk.
Oi Seahawks.
Hola Seahawks.
Hey Seahawks.
And today I'm going to talk about Latinos. When we say Latinos, we are talking about all Latin America, like Mexico, Honduras, Guatemala, Venezuela, Colombia, Brazil, and a lot more. One of the things that you may not know about Latinos is what kind of traditional stuff we do in our country, what kind of music we listen to, what kind of food we eat, what kind of clothes we wear. Let's take a look. Mexico. Mexicans are not only those people with big sombrero like you think they are. We have a lot of traditions. We do wear those sombreros, but not every day. We wear them when we dance the traditional mariachi dance.
Yo no soy marinero. Yo no soy marinero. Por ti seré, por ti seré, por ti seré. Bamba, bamba. Bamba, bamba. Bamba, bamba.
The mariachi dress is one of our traditions. Well, let me show you how it is. In other countries, they have different kind of dances. Like Puerto Rico has reggaeton. República Dominicana has the bachata. And Venezuela, Colombia, and others have merengue. Like you see, every Latino country has different traditions, but it's only one thing that puts all those Latino countries together. That is soccer. You may not know, but almost all Latinos like to play, watch, or teach soccer. I'll see you next time with RJ International Show to talk about another great country.
Wow, RJ, you guys are really talented.
So, Alex, I wonder what movies are coming out soon.
I believe the Hunger Games are coming out. Here, check this out.
Time for Hawk Tall Entertainment.
So how many of you are dying to see the new movie, The Hunger Games, which comes out March 23rd?
Which movie is that again?
The one where one boy and one girl from ages 12 to 18 are in a battle to the death.
We could do it, you know. Take off, live in the woods.
They'd catch us.
Well, maybe not.
We wouldn't make it 5 miles.
Tribute.
That sounds exciting.
You know what else is exciting?
What?
The final season of Jersey Shore.
That's right. This season was full of fights and drama.
Let's just see how crazy this season was.
Arrivederci! Jersey, here we come!
Peace out, Italy.
Basically, what it all comes down to,
I love Seaside High School, Jersey, this time of year.
This is the best time of my life.
People's down!
Hurricane situation, and it's heading straight for Snooki Island.
Go home.
You sure this is what you want to do?
Yeah, bro. Love you, bro.
Me too, man.
It's real. This is a reality right here. Vinny is out of here.
I feel like the house, it's like broken now.
You need the house full. Vinny's not around. I'm looking for more people right now.
New roommates?
That's a hot mess. I can't believe only one episode is left.
You know Pauly D is going to have his own show, right?
That's right. The Pauly D Project premieres March 29th on MTV, of course.
Me, I'm just a small town boy from a small state called Rhode Island. I live literally in the same house as my dad.
Yo, I always knew you'd be something.
And then my mom, she just lives like 5 minutes away. I used to scratch all your turntables, ruin all your records.
You were beating that beat from early on.
Jersey Shore made me famous, but now it's time for me to show the world what I'm all about.
Are you kidding me?
The Palms, Las Vegas, they want me to spin there. So I'm taking my boys with me along for the ride. Biggie, he's my mentor. He taught me how to spin.
Everybody move out!
Jerry, he's my security, he's my body, he's my dude.
Yeah, buddy!
And then I got Ryan, he's my best friend, he's my wingman. This is my posse right here, the Pauly D posse.
See you next time!
Good to see you.
This is the biggest thing I've ever done. I'm signing a record deal with 50 Cent. I'm about to take the stage for 20,000 people in Puerto Rico for Britney Spears.
So I prove that dreams do come true.
Life is short, and I'm just happy I have the opportunity to be able to take my boys along with me.
Yeah!
Seahawks.
Wow, that was really intense.
Well, alright, Seahawks. I'm Ashley.
And I'm Alex. Well, we'll catch you later on next week's Hawk Talk edition. Mm-hmm.